can we start for people who haven't experienced the film yet, just with a brief synopsis of Philly Brown?
Yeah, absolutely. Philly Brown is the story of this wonderful, young, talented musician, rapper, who wants to so hard to make and wants so hard for the world to like see the gifts that she possesses. And she goes on this musical journey. At the same time, at home, there's a lot of problems. Her dad, she's being raised by a single dad. Her mom's in prison. And when we meet her, her mom asks for her help. So she's faced with this decision to help her mom, and it affects all her decisions in her music. So because of this, she's at the precipice of stardom, things start to happen that's trying to throw everything out of whack for her. So it's how she recovers from that and how the family sort of recovers from everything.
It's an incredible journey for a character. Gina, can you talk a little bit about what excited you about playing Philly?
Wow, I mean, besides the opportunity of being able to enter a whole new world of art, to be able to rap and sing, and that was something I had never touched before, that was definitely a huge, huge excitement for me to jump into that. Also, having a strong Latina female lead, you know, second, third generation, you know, American who is super assimilated into American culture yet has this other culture back home, and that's my story, pretty much, you know, like I'm born in Chicago from Puerto Rico, but for me, it's a journey that I'm still on, you know. I mean, besides the fact that Philly Brown is still happening and we're here in London, it's a journey of following your dreams and trying to fix all the wrongs in your life and realizing that you're only human and you can only do so much. And the choices you make have to be built on truth and have a foundation of gratitude and generosity and modesty. And when you don't have that, it falls. And that's a journey that I will continue to be on as an actress. So for me, it really was a slice of life, and a slice of life that I, you know, with the whole rapping and the being a matriarch of a family was something I hadn't experienced yet. So I went on a new journey with Philly Brown, and I'm still kind of on the journey with her. So it's kind of beautiful.
I have to follow that up. I'm amazed to hear that rap is something that you kind of came to for this film. I mean, how did you go about, because on screen I think you wouldn't for a second think that it's not just been part of this character's makeup for just, you know, her entire existence.
Thank you, Russell. I appreciate that. I feel really blessed to have parents who always encouraged me, you know, if you just take a leap of faith, if you just jump off that cliff, God will provide the parachute. And I really did that with Philly Brown, which was, we are capable of doing anything. We can imagine, we literally are capable of doing anything, you know, and all of us are creative and everybody has art in their blood, and like, we're made by the ultimate artist. And, you know, for me, it's, they gave me a new passion. They gave me a new life form. They gave me a new therapeutic outlet. They gave me a new way to talk to the kids that I want to be a role model for, you know. And for me, I was like, why not go hard or go home, go all in, you know, and just do the best you can. And that's really all you can do. So I did that, and now you can't get me out of the studio because I'm all like, it's rapper time.
I mean, are you actually going to take the music thing forward? Are we actually going to really see music?
Oh yeah. I've been lucky enough to work with a lot of great producers. There were labels that were interested.
She's been on the road, too. Yeah, she's live performances already.
I've done live performances. And I'm doing some of my own music that isn't as much rapping. It's a little more like folk. And there's not many Puerto Rican folks artists, so.
Not as many as there should be. We need at least one.
Exactly. At least one more. So.
Get up a notch.
Yes.
Now, I mean, Michael, bring it back to you. I mean, this is a film that actually has a lot of different messages in it. On one level, it's about characters having the power for change. It's also, at the same time, about sort of staying true to who you are. I mean, what are you hoping audiences take away from Philly when they walk out of that theater?
I think, depending on who the audience member is, everybody will walk away with something. And I think it's about, you know, it's a story about hope. And I think everybody gets that. Everybody that sees it at the end feels that. Whether you're, you know, 50-year-old, you know, Caucasian lady, or a 15-year-old Latino kid, or, you know, 20-year-old African American kid. Everyone that's seen the movie has had a way into the story, and it's been very personal. It's like we've had really strong audience screenings. Like everyone is really moved by the story, and you know, like we had one gentleman who saw it, and he said, and he really related to Lou's character, to the father, because he's got a daughter, and he's like, if that happened to my daughter, that's exactly what I, you know. So, and very visceral, you know. So I'm hoping that everyone enjoys it and makes the movie their own, you know.
I mean, for both of you, what does the support of Sundance mean? I mean, especially bringing it here to London.
Amazing. I mean, we just had this question, and it's the same thing. It's they changed their lives.
They changed their lives. Yeah.
This has been a life-changing moment for both of us. I mean, for everyone, for Youssef, who's my directing partner, for our producers. Sundance, as an independent filmmaker, validates you.
Yes.
To the industry, to the world. I mean, it's
same as for an actor. Yeah. And I think it did that for all the actors in the cast, and even those that were already seasoned, like mm-hmm. Edward James Olmos and Lou Diamond Phillips. And, you know, for them, almost like a reinvigorating their love for the art. And, you know, and Sundance does that. And Sundance gives you confidence. And it's not this cocky, like, oh, I'm better than everybody because I went to Sundance. It's this, like, yes, keep doing what you're doing and don't stop doing it. You know, and like, when I got into Sundance, it was amazing. I was like, oh, you must be so amazing. And it's like, what it gave me was, you can do this, now don't stop. Yeah. Keep going. Yeah. Now go and make something even better, Gina. Because, like, I'm expecting to see you again. And I love that. It's this, you know, it's like a big brother being like, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. You did good, kid.
It's about, they open up a community. And then they're hands-on all the way through. I get emails from all the filmmakers, from the Sundance staff. So it's great. It's wonderful.
They're wonderful.
You're not out there alone by yourself anymore.
Yeah.